words ain't gonna help you, son. You'd be sorry for what you've done. Then God's gonna hurt you, son, when you play with a loaded gun.
It hasn't been 10 seconds, but I started a new episode. Hello, everyone. The professional scumbag is Sebastian. Yes, we're gonna go. We're gonna fly high to Rothas Lagoon. Oh, Queen Anne. This is where Queen Anne lives. We have to meet a giant alligator.
Ankle gators used to roam the wilds, and they nested at Rothas Lagoon.
Oh, hey, here's...
Many a tale folks used to scare their children straight originated here.
Boom jams.
All kinds of beasts what don't know up from down, still lurking about.
Oh, is that the right ways?
Can't get hasty in a place like this.
I didn't mean to, friend.
These beasts, they don't like company.
Hey, just jump that way again. I'm real bad at this game. Sneaky decoy. I'm gonna really rather not. Actually, that's what the Lost and Found is for, I believe. The Lost and Found... I'd really like to pick this up. But I really would like to also keep my actual... Unless there's an arsenal later on. No, I'm gonna... Just gonna not. Yeah, nope.
Even the brushers learn to fear this place. They used to think that ankle gators were extinct.
Oh, Dios mío.
Well, they ain't. One of them's been living in the tall grass.
Oh, don't follow me.
Turns out Queen Anne got a hold of a shard. Ankle gators love shiny things.
That's good to know. I'm glad they do.
They say you can't hurt an ankle gator unless it's raining. And it ain't raining. Most of those peckers are smart enough to stay out of Queen Anne's way.
Hey, what's over there to shoot? I was shooting something. Oh well. Ah.
The brushers use their pikes to keep their distance around here. Now the kid can do the same.
Beat a thrust, just like in real life. Oh god.
Bad idea to walk in gator grass.
I didn't really want to, but okay. Ah! Ah! This is hell. The wilds are hell.
Sharp sticks make Queen Anne nervous, so she backs off a bit.
I'd rather be north of the wall. That is not... That is... She's not backing up, she's still following.
Those pincushions been living off the ankle gator scraps. Queenie leads the kid into some kind of twisted trap. One bad step in that tall grass, and he's Queen Anne's lunch.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for making me nice and calm. You know, I was happy. I'm happy. Happy that you're telling me these horrifying tales. Rux. Little Rux. Like dinosaur. Like Rex. Rex the dinosaur. I really, really appreciate if you were to not. Why, once again, why am I trying to, like, counter when I have a gun?
He holds his ground. Seems the queen's running out of options.
Oh, no. Go out of here, queen.
Still no sign of the shard.
Yeah, I'll keep the brusher pike. And there was an arsenal, so I really should have taken the stealthy thing. Howie? Try it again. You go fall.
The closer you get to an ankle gator's lair, the thicker the tall grass grows.
Is it a Pokemon?
Kids gotta make a run for it.
Legitimate question, is an ankle gator a Pokemon?
That old gator's right on his tail. They make a tasty snack.
Oh, Jesus. Oh. Okay, I'm running. I'm running. Yeah. Didn't see that coming, did you? Ah, ooh, I didn't see that one coming. So it was almost too late.
Seems even stinkweeds know to stay away from the queen.
I see you begging for attention down there, Queenie, and I will be there in a moment. But I have things to do, like grab something pointy. Which really is not a good idea. Because, like, it'll poke you. No. Don't give. Can I get a super repel?
Ankle gators don't much care for their young. That's why there ain't many around. Wanna know how to find an ankle gator lair? You use a kid as bait.
That's just rude,
frankly. The
shard's
sitting in plain view. He's got it, and now to finish her off. Now she's coming for him. She's got nowhere else to go.
Bam jams.
She's starting to get annoyed. They say if you run across an ankle gator, you better keep running.
I am trying. But she's not having it.
And now he's made her mad.
Look, I'm sorry, ma'am, please calm yourself. I'd really rather not.
Rest in peace, Queen Anne.
Thank you.
That was for the brushers.
I know, game, but I want to explore the area first. There might be loot. Look, there's some loot. Look, there's more loot. I didn't want to do that. I meant to do this. Bam jams. Okay, now we may go back to the wonderful lands. That is the bastion.
What needed to be done.
El bastion. Wait, that's French. That's Spanish.
Queen Anne's reign is over. We even got a crown jewel.
When does
still
this...
no mail. Go figure.
But I really want there to be mail.
That gator's a crazy gal. But so is the gal who promised to look after her.
Oh, Zia, you got a little friend? I got Squirt, you got Ankle Gator. Rux has got Pith. And then Zolf has got himself. Because he's a traitorous scumbag.
They said Queen Anne was just a folktale. Now there's living proof she ain't.
On top of it is a pool. It's a pool and everything. Alright. Do you have Pike Vault? Something coarse. Yeah, you do have that, but I don't really want it, to be frank. My name's not Frank. Get it? Because I'm not Frank. I don't get it either. I'll go back to my war machete if I could. Nothing new for the forge. At least not for our weapon. Oh, whoops. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna do.
All that trouble for a single shard. But you know what? It was worth it.
I'm sure it was. Actually, it might be if I can get some good from the Lost and Found.
We need an awful big Lost and Found under the circumstances.
Pointy, fancy, greasy area.
Finders keepers.
Nothing sharp. Just unfortunate, because I need my something sharps. Ricochet, yeah, ricochet.
That ought to give those dueling pistols a little extra kick.
Might be some more, something sharps.
The next shard should be farther out there in the wild.
Let's try the brusher. I think there might have been one here. And
to
we can also
prepare for the wilds. Ceylandia's brushers practice at Camp Dunsey.
Oh, just on Nancy. Nasty.
Had to navigate a maze of pincushions with nothing but a pike.
I'll give it a shot. I'm really bad at this one.
It's a dangerous test for a dangerous job. Health tonics were off limits at Camp Dunsey. They said they made you weak.
Ow. So bad. Okay. That one? Yeah, to get first prize, you have to do this in a minute. I ain't doing it in a minute.
Rules said he couldn't use any fancy footwork, just your brains and your bike.
No, that's the wrong way. Yep, we got out of this way. Through Hell Zone. Yeah, and rank 2 is at a minute 30, I believe. Which we might be able to make.
Did all right at Camp Dunsey. You got to go to the wilds.
Hooray. Things we'll never use. I wonder if there are any mother?
You can see why the brushers prize those pikes of theirs.
I suppose. I mean, they're kind of useful in those specific situations. And we never in here. There might be something sharp up in here. I'm just going everywhere for all these places for crafting.
No place
materials.
Better than Trapper Shingle for learning to tread light and shoot straight.
No, but that is something greasy, which is
Trappers
what they need.
Trappers had to tread real carefully, or else take a nasty fall.
I can do pretty well in this, but
they
I can't get
themselves by clearing out the targets while not clearing out the floor.
I do pretty well at this, but I can't
knows
shut
never
up.
To take a step till the time is right.
But I cannot do it first place. I can't get first place in this. Maybe like, but look at it, you're wrecking everything. I'll be like, yeah, I know, I'm just so amazing, but it gets real hard later on. Right about here. because maybe it's really hard. I missed one. Oh well.
Expert trappers got something extra to give them an edge.
Some burnt, or no, some greasy is what I want. This is what I need as well. I would use the restart button, but nope. I ain't done do that
to
again.
To think a rickety place like the shingle survived, and so little else did.
Well, it all fell down now, and I didn't it. Oh, I don't have any money. All that, I don't have money. Well, let's do a mission. If I really wanted to, I could. You know what? Let's get some quick cash. And by get some quick cash, I mean subject ourselves to horrors.
Poor kid collapses after just one drag.
Here we learn the kid's depressing backstory.
The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history.
Welcome to who knows where. It's hell. It's hell incarnate. It's literally hell. Actually, maybe it is literally hell. I think the god's effects are a lot more ramped up in here.
The past catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie.
My thumb is just gonna be broken after this.
He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his.
Self-shat.
Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there.
See them crits? Mad crits, yo. And now they have no dread realm. There are no more crits.
School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it.
That kind of confused me. Why did you say the elements? Like, does the rippling wall, like, defend against bad weather? Like, or are the people on there, like, I don't know.
Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too.
Damn it. Do not hurt this. love that ability so much. Sir, sir, could you not?
The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either.
Yeah, that didn't do as much damage as I hoped. No, don't you hurt me. I'd really rather not. Can you not put your pickaxes away?
So what'd the kid do? Why he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years?
Be part of the Night's Watch, going to the wall. Slam jams!
In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls.
I'm just so cool. With my incredibly large upper body. Break the box.
In time, the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody.
Yeah, just send a kid. It's like, we need to send troops to the Hell Death Peninsula. Who should we send? We're sending the kid. Okay, yeah, send in this one little white-haired orphan boy. Nothing could possibly go wrong. And then they see him do that, and then it's like, okay, yeah. He's pretty much fine. Just give him two pistols and he's gonna wreck everyone. This kid is incredibly versatile, because he only knew how to use the hammer.
One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that.
Hey, buddy. Oh, you're dead. I got the shotgun. Shotgun rain. Could you not, friends?
All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back.
And they also have health tonics, but that's a whole nother dealio. Hey, Mr. Scumbags.
Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him.
I'm still confused. Does he actually hear the narrator's voice? Or what is it? said. Do they have a psychic link? I'm pretty sure they do, actually. Because, like, later on, you get so far away from the Bastion that he's like, I can't hear him anymore. So, and Rux says, like, I can't hear the kid anymore. So maybe Rux has some kind of psychic power. Whee!
Finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaulted safe haven. He and no one else.
Oh, oh good. I have one health tonic. God, I would like a black tonic right now. That'd be really helpful. Really, really helpful. So I could use my, badass thingy. Yes, the good music. Oh, my favorite song.
But then, all I got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name.
Yeah. You dick. Oh, you're this dickbag Towers. I really like using the pistols. I might use them a bit too much. I don't know if I'm supposed to switch up or not. Cause like I have that gamer instinct of if it works.
Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the Bastion, but the kid made him real. Not me.
Oh cow. Oh, cows. Oh, cows. Oh, cows. This is my last one. Last reflection. I need to beat it. Tank him, tank him, tank him, tank him.
I'd like to say I'll never forget him or what he's doing. What he's done.
Wait, what?
I surely would.
Wait, what do you mean by that? Oh boy, old pal. Rux? Oh, now I woke up. Right, now we have the money we need, I believe. Yes.
You'd never guess those things been to the wilds and back.
And now, at 156 shards, I will end this here episode. In the exact same place. Because I was right here, remember? I think so. I always start and end the episodes right here. Usually. I don't know. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. That's Jack. That's Jacksepticeye who so says that. Except he says like high fives and stuff. I don't know how to high five. You just go like, and he's like, that's a high five. I just slap my controller hand. Both controller and the hands. Okay, and so press the button so you don't look like more of a douchebag. No, I'll look like a little douchebag I want. And shut up, me. You kook.